Morning guys, my name's Alan Hart and today I'm doing day in the life of a plumber. So I'm doing a power flush today, but it's a power flush with a little bit of a difference because one of the pipes has got so bad it's actually blocked. So it's going to be a little bit tricky. So normally we'd come, we'd just do a power flush and that's fine, you know, that's just another day at the office. But when we've got a pipe that's blocked, it's a lot more tricky because you can't get the chemicals to go into the system where you want it to go to flush it. So we've got to get flow through it so we can get the chemicals through it. So what I've got is I've got a little trick today. So I'm going to take the radiator valve off and I'm going to pump some air into it just to try and unblock it. And then we'll see if we can get power flush machine to go around it then. And if we can, then we should have cracked it. So let's go inside, let's go and have a look. So this is the offending radiator here. So this radiator just will not get warm. So the pipe on the left gets a little bit warm, but there's no water flow through it. So even when we take this pipe off here, no water comes out of that pipe on the right hand side. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get a foot pump and I'm gonna try and I'm going to put some pressure in that pipe and I'm going to see if we can unclear the blockage in it. So we'll do that now. So I'm going to pump a bit of pressure in it now and see what happens. So we've connected the power flush machine in now, we've put a chemical in and this has been flushing around now for a little while. So we just connect it in, pump adapter, net boiler. So we can see there, we've got some flow coming into it now. It's still not brilliant. So I'm just going to reverse the flow on this now. And then we'll see if that makes a difference. So we can clearly see the difference now. We've actually got flow through the bottom of the radiator. We didn't have that before. Right, let's have a look at this one now. It feels a lot warmer as we're coming here already. So let's get thermal imaging camera on this. So this is the Seek thermal imaging camera. We've got 60 degrees there now, coming into the radiator, and it's a lot warmer now. So I think we've cracked it. Machine only goes up to about 60 degrees. So I think we've cracked it. I think it's doing what it needs to do now.
So the problem we had with this radiator was this pipe is Microbore, and it had blocked up over the years. But we've managed to get it clear now and it's fully working. So what I'll do is I'll add a little clip on end just to show you temperature at radiators now with my thermal camera. And yeah, thanks for watching.
So if we can see on there now, it's 69 degrees. The actual full radiator is really hot, but this thermal camera is not very good, to be honest. I'm going to go back to my flare, I think.